In this interview, I will be talking with Jim Blair and Jesse Keating about Zuul. Can you start by just introducing yourselves and telling us what projects you work on, either just Zuul or if things in peripheral to that?
Sure. I'm Jim, and I've been working with the OpenStack project for several years now. And I was one of the founding members of the project infrastructure team. And as part of our work helping the project grow over time, we developed this program called Zuul that we're here to talk about.
I'm Jesse, and I've also been in the OpenStack community for a number of years. I started off as an operator, helping to do deployments of OpenStack for a very large public cloud. In that capacity, I also discovered and fell in love with Ansible and have contributed a lot around Ansible, particularly Ansible in the OpenStack community. And that has kind of led me over the years to become involved in Zuul as Zuul started moving towards using those types of things as well. These days, I'm less involved in OpenStack in general, but more specifically involved in Zuul and with being able to use Zuul with alternative platforms to what OpenStack is using.
So Zuul was born in OpenStack, but like you say, is now used by other communities. Let's start by, what's Zuul?
So Zuul is a CI system and is growing into a continuous deployment system as well. We developed it for OpenStack to deal specifically with the large number of interrelated projects that OpenStack has. So we have a lot of projects that are all changing all the time. Changes in one project might affect another or might require changes in another in order to be effective. And Zuul helps with the testing of all of those by allowing developers to sort of express the relationship between changes in multiple projects, make sure everything is tested together the way that it's going to end up in the tree before it actually lands. A central aspect of Zuul is what we call project gating, which is when there's no individual person in any of the OpenStack projects that has the authority to just push a change into Git. All of the changes have to go through Zuul. They have to be tested and pass their tests before they can land in the repository. And Zuul does that for us and helps us out there. So Zuul started out very much tailored to OpenStack's problem space as well as our development environment and our tooling. So it started out talking directly to Garrett, our code review system, and since then we've evolved it to talk to other systems and to run the actual job content using new technology.
Yeah, I think to build onto that. In one of my roles, we were developing our own OpenStack product, and we had many changes that had to live on top of OpenStack, and our developers wanted a way to maintain those changes and work with those changes as close to upstream OpenStack as possible. And in that frame of mind, we developed what's called a third-party CI, a duplicate of the OpenStack infrastructure CI system. So that included our own Garrett, our own test running infrastructure, and our own Zuul. And we set all that up and had our developers using that, validating their changes, getting reviews and sign-offs, and having their changes pass all the tests, which allowed a greater sense of confidence in the code that we are writing, and a greater sense of confidence in our product. As we exposed more and more of our developers to this way of developing software, it became very clear that this development style, this having a gating system that not only prevented the changes from going in until they pass the tests, but it would also allow you to set up dependencies between multiple changes and allow maintainers to review large sets of changes, pass judgment on them saying that they're good to go, and once all the tests have passed and all the different parts have passed, the system would automatically merge that for them. It was a very, very good workflow for a lot of our developers, and they asked us to figure out a way to apply this workflow to all the other software projects they were working on, which definitely led us towards making Zool operate in a way that wasn't specifically OpenStack and it wasn't specifically on Garrett, hence the new feature of being able to run Zool connected to GitHub, one of the more popular source control and review software review systems in the world.
Now, later this week, I'm going to be talking with Monty about some other communities that are using Zool, and so I won't ask you to talk about that, but when you were abstracting that from OpenStack to this larger problem set, what kind of challenges did you encounter there?
So, as Jim said, Zool grew in a very constrained or at least a very specific environment, and that was OpenStack development. It was on top of Garrett. It was building from previous CI systems and iteratively replacing the pain points until eventually there was nothing of the old system left and it was all just Zool. Taking that and trying to extract it from the OpenStackness and from this very specific use case of one very, very large tenant and trying to put it somewhere else where you have many, many, many projects that aren't related to each other and they don't have a way of sharing job names and project names, and there's a lot of collisions that could happen. That was a difficult thing. The good part of that story is that Jim and the rest of the infrastructure team had already started down a path of changing how Zool was structured internally and how Zool was put together to better facilitate usage outside of OpenStack. And they were in the process of a rewrite around the same time that my team wanted to make use of it on something else. And so we had a front row seat to the direction that the rewrite was going. We had an opportunity to provide time, code, and opinions on that rewrite. I believe that because of our experience of trying to create this more general use mini tenant setup, helped with the vision and helped with the direction in that rewrite to get us to where we are today, where Zool is far better suited for usage outside of that very specific OpenStack world.
That's definitely true, and it's been great having the perspectives from you and some of the other contributors as we've been doing this, because you know in OpenStack we talk to a lot of people and we see a lot of things and we can try to internalize that, but it's really good to have folks come to the table and say, hey, we're trying to use it this way. We need to do this in order for to do what we want to do, and that's definitely helped to evolve the. Evolve the project. And something occurred to me while you were talking in that there are certainly some differences between that we had to deal with when we added GitHub into the mix, into a system that was designed originally for Garrett. At the end of the day, though, it sort of continually surprises me the number of similarities. When you get to the point where you've sufficiently abstracted the issue so that you're dealing with a workflow where somebody wants to make a change and you want that to be reviewed and you want it to be tested, that's ultimately a very universal concept.
Yeah, it is.
And so Zool is sort of we're starting to see it bridge communities and workflow styles And again, I won't jump too much into what Monty's likely to talk about later. But we are a big something that we're very excited about is the fact that Zool is able to bridge these communities both in a technical and a social sense. Who knows, we may be adding more systems in the future if we've if we have abstracted it this far to handle these two systems. Hopefully we've got ourselves in a good place to add more.
OpenStack is fascinating to me in exactly that regard, because more than any other project I've worked with, it's this confluence of all these seemingly unrelated communities. So it's a really exciting community to work with in that respect. We have this brief moment this week between Queens and Rocky, where we take a breath and step back and see what's next. What's next? What are you going to be working on in the coming 6 months?
We're finishing up the version 3 release of Zool right now, which is this major rewrite that we've been talking about that adds GitHub support as well as the actual job content in Zool is defined in Ansible. Those are sort of the two of the marquee features for version 3. As we go forward, we're looking at integrating more native container use cases into the system, finding a way to test both workflows on containers as well as a very native CI workflow for testing container-based projects themselves. We think that Zool is actually well positioned to deal with both of these and possibly more container-based use cases. So I think that's the one of the big things we're looking at. Zool is a fairly scalable system, but we're
that's
looking,
an understatement.
We're looking to there's always a little bit more we can do, so we're going to be looking to improve the scale out story a little bit. I think that's enough to keep us busy for a while.
Yeah, what Jim says is correct. There's from my perspective as somebody who wasn't necessarily in the OpenStack infrastructure community, who wasn't part of the day-to-day operation of Zool in that context, we learned quite a lot about operating Zool, and we brought a fresh approach to it that has led to some of these future plans. The way that the OpenStack infrastructure runs their Zool, they've got a very long history of some very highly capable people keeping that system running, and some very mature systems for deploying and managing and things like that. But coming at it from a scrappy little startup within a much larger company, we only had a few people. We tried using a new, not, I'm sorry, we approached it with Ansible, a tool that we knew, and spent a lot of time figuring out exactly how we can deploy it, how small we can deploy it, which parts we needed to deploy multiple of, which led to some of the scale-out ideas and some of the V3 rewrite as well. Approaching it, and as we talk about containers, we're also talking about running Zool as a cloud-native, container-native thing, which is a little different than how the OpenStack Infra works. And so that's leading to some of the what Jim was talking about of how do we auto scale some of the parts that are important to scale as a Zool usage grows. And then how do we, the OpenStack community has the benefit of having many OpenStack clouds at their disposal for the actual capacity of running tests. And there are many organizations that donate a fair amount of capacity for that cause. Outside of the OpenStack community, that is one of the bigger barriers to Zool being used or deployed by people outside of OpenStack, is that there's a fairly hard requirement on there being an OpenStack cloud that it can make use of. furthering the approach to containers and being able to perhaps one day say you don't need an OpenStack cloud. You can just point it at a cloud of containers or a container orchestration engine and use that as your capacity. That'll be a pretty fundamental change in the requirement set for Zool. And you know, it's just a fairly large piece of work that will have to be done. But we couldn't really start on that until we get V3 done.
What do you wish that the developers on the various OpenStack sub-projects knew or did differently when they're interacting with what you guys do?
I think the reaction has been very positive so far, and I'm really actually excited to see what folks have come up with. A big part of what we've done in Zool V3 is decentralized the configuration so that every developers in all of the individual OpenStack projects can add a little bit of Zool configuration in their own repository. And in doing that, we've actually seen some folks have been really excited about that, and I guess the new capabilities that brings them. So some of the things that we've seen are because of this decentralized configuration that we have now, we have folks that are able to sort of on their own without involving the project infrastructure team, they've started uploading Docker images to Docker Hub and things like that. These are things that before we'd have to, you know, somebody would have to come to the infrastructure team and we'd have to set up an account and build all of this infrastructure before anybody can come in and do that sort of thing. Now folks can do this on their own and get things started without us being a bottleneck. Now that doesn't mean that everybody's on their own and they have to figure out everything out from scratch. But because of the way Zool allows sharing of configuration between different projects, the work that folks have, you know, the first person that's come along and figured out how to tell Zool to upload an image to Docker Hub, the next people can come along and take advantage of that and reuse the same content. So I think to sort of more directly answer your question, I think the challenge ahead for us is letting people know how much power that they have individually now, and you know, how much initiative they can take to do this, but then also keeping that, making sure that other people know about it and surfacing that so that other projects can say, oh, that's something I'm interested in, let's collaborate on that.
Yeah, I would echo that because with V3, configuration is not centralized, as Jim said. Each project has the capability of defining their own jobs and their own job content. And as we spoke before, the job content is Ansible, which is, you know, it's a fairly low barrier of entry to doing some fairly complex things. And so with that, people are now able to experiment on their own with these types of changes. So, you know, Zool is sort of self-referential. If you make a change to your test content and to your test, Zool will go ahead and read that and make use of that in testing your change to change the test. And so end users are able to very quickly experiment with a very fast feedback loop on, you know, what if I change this test this way? What if I add this test? What if I try this new random experiment that you know, was much, much harder before? So users have an almost infinite amount of power and capability to experiment with and to come up with some really amazing things that you know, we never would have thought of. But at the same time, you know, if they find something cool, like bubble that up, because not only could it be useful to other consumers in the OpenStack community, but the way that we're structuring Zool and with shared content is that you know, we can create a library of jobs that are shared amongst all of the, not just all of OpenStack as one consumer of Zool, but we can actually share these across all the consumers of Zool. So my installation of Zool can share job content with OpenStack's installation of Zool, and we can, as individual installations, we can also collaborate on making some of that base level job better and providing a library of very useful things that can be expressed very simply to consumers.
Thank you very much for your time, and thanks for all your hard work on Zool.
Thank you.
Thank you.